greet you this morning to be together as a body of Christ, give him our praise and our worship. I enjoy hearing the conversation, but I hope you were listening to those great old hymns that Sue was playing and kind of get your juices flowing, ready for an hour of celebration. As always, a few announcements before we get started. I've seen some of you passing the covenant of friendship, so be sure to do that if you have not yet done that. Sunday school classes for everyone at 10:30. And the church directory is available online. Thank you, Marty. Thursday, the choir practice for the chancel choir at 7 and bell choir at 8-ish. It's good to be back together. I appreciate Ryan's willingness to step up and be our leader. I guess this would be November 4th. That's coming up fairly quickly. The NOW Committee and the 19th Church Council. Great old ministry.
The annual charge conference.
Annual charge conference also. So for everyone, put that on your calendar. Church council will be at 6:30, but the charge conference will be at 7:30. Everyone is welcome to attend, and everyone has voice and vote on those matters. The Cradle Ministry for August James is out. And speaking of grandchildren, Fred has a brand new great-grandson named Freddie. Congratulations. And the Cappy and the proud parents, but thought that was worth mentioning. Disaster relief. If you are wanting to donate to the disaster relief through the Global Methodist Church, just mark on the memo part of your check, or if you're putting in cash or an envelope, or if you give online, you can designate, and we will make sure it gets to the proper place. The harvest dinner. big plans. This Friday night, November 1st, from 5 to 7. For those of you who signed up to work, you should be here at 3:45 for detailed instructions for what you are supposed to be doing and when you are supposed to be doing it. Do I have that right, Pat? So please, for those of you who volunteered, do the best you can to be here at 3:45. At 4 o'clock, start with, or 3:45, and at 4 o'clock, we'll start putting together the meals for Manly Heights. And then, if you've worked that dinner before, about that time, all chaos breaks out, but we keep it as organized as possible. Have a great time, and the money raised will go for our hurricane disaster relief. So thank you, one and all. And to you husbands that want to treat your wife to a night of not having to cook, it's takeout. Come on in and fill it out and say, honey, I'm home, I have dinner, you don't have to cook, and I'll clean up. That styrofoam handles pretty quickly. Yes, Blair.
If you signed up to bring any type of food, please have it here by Wednesday. So if I have to run to the store real quick, I'll know what I need. So thank you for signing up. Thank you for volunteering. Thank you for coming. And it's fun working it together. So just come and enjoy.
Okay. On Thursday, Sissy Montgomery is still looking for help from 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock to do some gift wrapping. We also know that that's a day that there's a lot of work going on to prepare the food for Friday's harvest dinner. But if you're not involved with the harvest dinner and want to do some Christmas wrapping, Sissy is going to do that from 10 to 2. And if you have excess wrapping paper that you're wondering, do I throw it in the trash or do I donate it? She is looking for additional paper to wrap her gifts. The prayer shawls are now in the nursery area, and if you need one for yourself or someone you know, and can't find them, talk to Blair. She will get you one, show you where they're at. Speaking of babies, John and Andrea Wolf are expecting their baby to be born tomorrow, at last word. So,
Inducing her because her blood pressure went up.
She's going to be induced, so keep John and Andrea in your prayers. Nice insert in your bulletin. Please take note of that. And one more announcement. Sean, if you'd like to come on up.
Thank you, Mark. Harvest dinner. I think Mark was saying men don't cook. Is that what you heard?
It's an easy way to cook.
Oh, an easy way to cook. And saying that, Blair, are you the cook? I married Lisa because she cooks, just so you know.
Oh,
love your babe.
I think you're sorry,
Lisa. It was one of the reasons I married her. But maybe I will take her out to the harvest dinner, you know what I'm saying? A couple things here this morning. Just a reminder, this month, staff appreciation, pastor appreciation is wrapping up here. Not that you have just 1 month to do that, but just a reminder around that. And at council, we did approve raises for our staff, so that's a good thing to be able to do. And for us to be able to do that, of course, you know why I'm standing up here, right? Eric, you can imagine why I'm up here, right? Because we're given raises. People deserve some raises. And how do we pay for that? We call the government up and they give us money, right? No, that's not how that works. Steve, that doesn't work this way, you know what I'm saying? So at any rate, just be prayerfully considering as we go into November and Thanksgiving and Commitment Month, right? Where we talk about our commitment to our family here at First Global. Remember that we have things that we need to pay for this ministry, and just want to encourage you to prayerfully consider that. If you ever are curious, Barry does a nice job at council of providing us with updates on how we're doing financially, but there's a bulletin board down there if you are so inclined to learn about the finances of our church and, you know, just understand how you're a part of that. So that would be appreciated as well. So those are the couple of things that I had on my list this morning. Back to Mark. Thank you.
And I understand congratulations are due to our band last night for doing well in their band competition. So, there you go, kids. Any other announcements? Then let us pray together. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh upon us. Come into this place and fill us with your Holy Spirit. May we hear you speaking to us, and may we feel your arms wrapping around us in this hour of worship. And may our worship be found acceptable in your sight. In Jesus' name, amen. And now, as you are so led and able, if you would care to stand and join with the Rock of Refuge as we sing our two opening songs, Shine, Jesus, Shine, and Reckless Love.
Side of the world, shine upon us, turn. Holy, overwhelming. deserve it. Still you give yourself away. Holy, overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
Take God's love for granted. It's good to be reminded of his reckless love and his tremendous sacrifice that he gave for each one of us. Let us pray together. Oh Lord God, we do indeed give you our thanks for your reckless love. A love that will not let us go, that chases us to the lowest depths, wraps your arms around us, picks us up, dusts us off, says, I love you. Thank you for that. You are indeed the creator of all, and we give you our thanks and we give you our praise. We do give you thanks for this season of the year and where we live, that we can enjoy the beauty of fall, those fall colors, the crisp air. But we can come into a warm and comfortable place. We are still mindful of those of the past weeks and months that have been, their homes, their lives have been turned upside down because of the hurricanes or fires. And in other countries, because of wars that seem to have no real reason for being, except for the evil that dwells in men's hearts. Lord, we ask for your spirit to revive us, to renew the spirit within us, that we might seek peace. Lord, as we've come together this morning, we continue to pray for the families who have lost loved ones this week, for the family and friends of Seth and for Cliff, and for all those who mourn, may they indeed be comforted by your Spirit. We pray for those continuing to be recovering from the hurricane, and we pray especially this morning for our former secretary and her husband, Robin and Jim. I understand they lost a lot of stuff. And they are grateful that it was only stuff and not their lives, but please be with them as they continue to rebuild. And for the many on our prayer list, among them are Sue and Tom and Ann and Buster, Sandy and Debbie, Jennifer and Mary Lou. And the list goes on and on, Lord. You know those names, you know those circumstances, you know the need. We lay them before you, knowing that you hear. And again, asking that you be present in their lives, and may they feel your arms around them. We are grateful for the ministries of this church, for the faithfulness of this membership. And we pray this week that you would be with us as the final preparations are made for the harvest dinner. May it be a successful time of fellowship and a witness to the community, but also that money might be raised for the hurricane relief. As we approach election day again, we pray for the gift of discernment. It is hard to really understand the politician's position by listening to the TV ads. So give us the gift of discernment, that the persons we choose to be our leaders might be ones that might be faithful to the gospel. And as always, we pray for relief from the scourge of drugs and violence on our streets, and for the wars that rage. We pray for Pastor Lee. Be with her and give her your blessing and the strength that she needs to be our shepherd for this flock. And for this congregation, we are so grateful that we come together, and we pray that the work that we do might be acceptable to your sight, and others might be drawn to you. Lord, for all those things that remain on our heart, we lay them before you, knowing and believing that you hear and that you will answer. And now we ask that you hear our prayer as we join our hearts and our voices together as we pray the prayer you taught your disciples when you prayed. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. This morning we have a special treat. We've heard Ryan play before, but this morning he and Kathy have a duet that I think Rosemary's exact words were, just put a chill down her spine. It is a beautiful piece of music and a beautiful duet, and Ryan, thank you. Thank you. How great thou art.
Thank you. Wow. Wow. Thank you. We are so blessed with all our musicians here. Amen?
Amen.
And, you know, I've told you many times before, and I'm going to tell you again, not all churches have this. Not all churches have this. And so whenever, when I think about that, we're just blessed. We're just blessed. Thank you. Thank you. And make sure the folks that sit at the organ and the piano don't always get the cred that they deserve. But, you know, we're pretty blessed there, too, with our organists and our pianists. So thank you. And then this morning, Kathy even learned to play bass for the praise band on the organ. Right? It sounded great. Sounded great. Not bad for a last minute addition, right? So appreciate that. The first scripture lesson I'm going to read now, and the second will be in the context of the sermon. But the first one is from Matthew's Gospel, the 5th chapter, verses 14 through 16. Jesus is speaking, Sermon on the Mount. And he says, "You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
I would invite you, as you are able, to stand and let us join together in number 585, "This Little Light of Mine." Be seated. Got a little children's message here this morning, so if there's any children that want to come down front, you can do that. I won't bite. Come on, Grayson. You can do it. Noah? Are we going to bring Addie down? No? Not yet. You can, hey, how about we have a seat right here in the front pew? Oh, you guys wanted to preach? Is that why you were going up there, as you wanted to preach? No? You don't want to preach. You're going to leave that to your grandmother, right? That's what I thought. Boys, girl. Always happens. I brought something with me today. You have any idea what it could be? No? I'll give you a hint. It's round, kind of. Yeah, pumpkin. It goes with that picture up there, huh? Yeah, a pumpkin. We see a lot of those right now, right? They're all over the place. So what do we usually do with them? I mean, you guys have pumpkins at your house? Yeah? You have two? So you just like leave it set somewhere? You have six. Oh my goodness.
And down the road, there's a
whole thing of them? Do you guys have any at your house? Yeah? You can buy them? Okay. Yeah, I had to buy this one. When I was little, my Aunt Betty used to grow them and we'd sell them to people. But we go pick out a pumpkin and what do? We just leave it? Put it on the porch? Okay. You carve it? Okay, so you just like cut the top off and put a face on it? Oh, you have to take the stuff out? Why do you have to do that? The candle would go out if you didn't take all that goop out, huh? Yeah. Is that what you guys do? Take all that stuff? Kind of messy, isn't it, though? Wouldn't it be easy just to, you know, stick a candle in it than to do all that other stuff? No? A box. I don't knock anything over. Ha ha! Now you know the choir members were wondering, or the praise band members. Yeah, this is a pumpkin. Look at that. There's still dirt on it. Are they always dirty? Yeah? No? They are. When they're in the field, they're dirty. They get dirty, don't they? But we usually brush them off, and then, you know, we cut the top off, right? And we clean out all the ugly stuff. This was all in there. It was pretty gross, too. I realize why I don't do this anymore. It was a mess. Look at all that stuff. And, you know, it's all sticky and gooey. Do you want to put your hand in it? No. Yeah, you would.
You want to?
You want to too? No, you're smart enough, right? Yeah, I don't want to do that. Right. So I took this out, cut the hole in the top, took it out, and then I cut, and I'm not really good, but I did cut a face on it. And you know what else I did? Maybe a candle. There we go. So I, you know, and if it was dark in here, we'd be able to really see that well, right? But you can see it. There's a story about a lady that was asked what it's like to be a Christian. She thought about it, and then she said, well, you know, it's kind of like being a pumpkin. Did you ever think of that? No, me neither. Well, you know, it's kind of like being a pumpkin because we go out when we want a pumpkin. We go out, a lot of us go out and we pick which one we want, right? And then we bring it home, we clean the dirt off of it, and then we clean, cut the top off, and we clean out all this horrible stuff inside, cut a face on it, and put a light inside, right? Well, you know what? God picks each of us. He created us. He created us because he loves us so much. So he picks us out. He cleans off the dirt, right? God cleans off the dirty stuff and gets rid of that in our lives. When we give him our heart, he cleans out all the yucky stuff that's inside, right? And he puts a new face on us, makes us smile, gives us a reason to live, right? And he puts his light inside so that we can shine his light for all the world, so that people can see in us, in our hearts, and in the way we live, they can see the light and the love of Jesus. So we kind of are, as Christians, we kind of are pumpkin-like, aren't we? Yeah. That's pretty cool, huh? So, as you see pumpkins this week, I want you to do something for me. This is kind of like homework. But don't worry, because I'm going to give them homework too. It's going to be a lot harder than yours. Doesn't that make you happy? I've always wanted to give homework. And, you know, it was really fun when I had teachers that I had in school that gave me homework. When they were in my church congregation, it was real fun to give them homework. But your homework, every time you see a pumpkin this week, I want you to say a prayer. And I want you to pray to ask God to take the gooky stuff out of your life, the bad stuff, and to clean me up and let his light shine through you so that the things you say and do show Jesus to the world. Can you do that? Whenever you see a pumpkin this week, pray that God's going to clean you up and let his light shine in your life. Let's pray. God, we thank you for pumpkins, and most often we thank you for your love, because we know that it is only through your love and your mercy that we can be cleaned up on the inside and the outside. And it's only through your love that we can reflect the light of Jesus Christ to all the world so that they can see you in us. Help us let your light shine for all the world to see in our hearts. And we thank you and we praise you for sending Jesus to love us and to save us and to give us his light. And all the children of God said, amen. Amen. After worship, I'm going to set a basket of candy up here and you guys can have some, but it's going to be after worship, okay? After church, all right? But, you know, candy is really what Halloween's all about, right? Yeah? Fist bump? Fist bump? Yeah! Because that's what Halloween's about, candy. And pumpkins. They remind us to be like Jesus, right? All right, thanks for coming down. You can head back now. I'm going to give the adults their homework assignment. Ha! There is a reason why I don't do pumpkins anymore. It was messy. It's been a long time since I've cut one out. Long time. Shadow never really cared for them, so, you know, why bother? And there was that story that I said. There was a lady that was asked by a coworker, you know, what's it like to be a Christian? And this was, it was probably this time of year, and that's why she was able to give her that example, that illustration. And probably before you heard that story, you probably would have said comparing a Christian and a pumpkin is just plain crazy, which you would expect from me, right? Crazy, yeah. But it really does make sense. And being the end of October, there are pumpkins all over the place. And rather than thinking of witches and headless horsemen each time you see a pumpkin, let it instead serve as a reminder to you of God's love and the gospel message of salvation through faith in Jesus Christ. Just as pumpkins are carefully picked out of the field, we too have been carefully picked by our Creator God. Our God chose to make us, to create us, each and every one of us. And our God chose to redeem us from the eternal death of sin through the sacrifice of His Son, Jesus Christ. Through the suffering death of God's own Son, all of humanity has been given the opportunity to be cleansed and to have our sin-caused broken relationship with God restored. We have been given the option of being brought in out of that dirty and dark field of sin and being washed clean and pure in the blood of Jesus Christ. The gift of salvation is offered to each of us if we would only believe that Jesus is the crucified and risen Son of God. Sounds pretty simple, right? Sounds pretty simple. Yet so much stands in the way of believing and living as God has called us to believe and to live. One obstacle that most of us face at one time or another is that we don't think we're dirty. We don't think we're dirty. There are many folks who know that they have a little dirt on the outside, you know, and they'll let God clean them up on those few Sundays, you know, during the holidays that they come to church. He'll, you know, get some of that dirt off the outside. And some folks will even let God clean them up every Sunday morning when they come to church. But then when they leave the church, they all just go right back out and they roll out into the darkness of the field and they get muddy and dirty again. The light and love of Jesus doesn't make it into their hearts and into their lives because many think that, well, they've received all the cleaning that is necessary. Far too many people think that it is enough to have the dirt rubbed off of the outside once in a while, so that they won't let God get close enough to take their top off. They won't let God take their top off because either they haven't admitted that there's a lot of yucky stuff on the inside too, or it's because they know there's a lot of yucky stuff on the inside and they want to hide it from God as if that's possible. Right? At one time or another, all of us have some yucky stuff in our lives that we either don't want to admit to, or we know it's there and we're going to try and hide it from God. Yet it is only when we admit to that yucky stuff, that yucky sin, it's only when we admit to that that God can start to remove it and make room for the light and the love of Christ. And in order for that light to continue to grow and shine for all the world to see, we need to not only allow God to take our tops off, and remove the yucky stuff from inside our hearts and our lives, we also need to allow God to put a smiling new face on us. And as God continually removes the yucky stuff from our lives, God continually makes us into new creations that allow the love and light of Jesus to shine for all the world to see. The writer of Ephesians talks about all of this, being a little more specific about some of the yucky stuff that we need to get rid of, and how to let the love and light of Jesus shine in our hearts. Listen to these words from Ephesians 5, 1 through 20. Follow God's example, therefore, as dearly loved children, and walk in the way of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. But among you there must not be even a hint of sexual immorality or of any kind of impurity or of greed, because these are improper for God's holy people. Nor should there be any obscenity, foolish talk, or coarse joking, which are out of place, but rather thanksgiving. For of this you can be sure: no immoral, impure, or greedy person, such a person is an idolater, and they have no inheritance, they don't have any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of such things, God's wrath comes on those who are disobedient. Therefore, do not be partners with them. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of the light, for the fruit of the light consists in all goodness, righteousness, and truth. And find out what pleases the Lord. Have nothing to do with the fruitless deeds of darkness, but rather expose them. It is shameful even to mention what the disobedient do in secret. But everything exposed by the light becomes visible, and everything that is illuminated becomes a light. That is why it is said, "Wake up, sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you." Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit, speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are to be imitators of God, children of the light, which means that we do need to be pumpkin-like. When we are pumpkin-like and allow God to cleanse us on the outside and the inside with the blood of Christ, we then become imitators of God and children of light. Then and only then will the light and love of Jesus Christ shine through our lives for all the world to see. Wherever you are, in your walk with God, if you want to be a pumpkin-like Christian, you need to admit to God and yourself how dirty and yucky you are on both the outside and the inside. You need to admit that it's only through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ that you can be cleansed. And you need to give all of your life to God so that you can be cleaned up and given a new smiling face and life that shines brightly with the love of Jesus for all to see. God is waiting to clean you up and make you a new creation so that you can shine forth with his light and his love. If you want to admit your yuckiness to God, whether it's for the first or the 101st time, but you're not really sure where to start, there's a prayer inside your bulletins called a sinner's prayer. Excellent, excellent place to start. Can be very helpful. Jesus is calling all of us. He wants us to come to him to be cleansed, to be made new, so that his light and love can shine through us now and always. Folks, we can claim victory over the yuckiness of this world and the sin that dims the light of Christ in our life. We can claim victory over that through Jesus Christ when we surrender our hearts and our lives to him. So I encourage you to claim that victory. Surrender your heart to God. Let him clean you up on the inside and the outside. And put his light and his love in your heart so that you can shine for all the world to see. Claim the victory. Go be like a pumpkin. Go be like a pumpkin. But make sure that you let the light of Christ shine through you every day. All God's children said,
amen.
Your homework's coming during the benediction, just so you know. Don't want you to feel left out, okay? Our closing hymn is a fun one, and so I hope you're ready for that. But before we go to the closing hymn, we are going to have the opportunity to present to God a portion of what we have been blessed with. As the ushers come forward so that we can gather our morning offering. Again, a reminder that you can donate online as well. You can give gifts for Bishop Abraham if you so choose through the offering plate, as well as hurricane relief. So.
Thank you.
pray together. We dedicate these gifts, Lord, for the work of your church, asking that you use all that we have and all that we are in your service. Amen. Let us claim the victory and let us sing as if we mean it, gang. Okay? Okay? Yeah, let's do it.